Hey, it's MK, and I am back for a little series that I wanted to end the year with. I got asked to create a baby album for a set of twins, and it was a boy and a girl, and I decided to record the process. Now, I have to say that these recordings were awful. Even this one, that's why I'm doing a voiceover. I tried to do what's it called? Real time. And because of the quietness, I have to be really quiet. I've got lots of noise in the background, and so the quality of the sound in the background is just awful. Plus, I take forever. You guys, I had no idea I talk this much. Seriously. Especially in this pink section. So I'm just fanning out all of the pink papers, and in real time, this was bad, you guys. How long can you talk about pink pieces of paper? But I'm trying to explain my little process of what, my thought process is, because when you have a newborn and all the way up to 1 year, a baby changes a lot in that time frame. And so I wanted the papers to reflect that change. And so that's basically what I'm saying here. And it just took way too long to say those five little words. So anywho, I want to apologize for being MIA for since November. I just had a lot going on. Several things happened in my life, and I really feel bad. So I'm going to try to pump out a video or two a day for you guys to smash out the end of the year 2020. And they are all going to be from this baby album. I hope you guys don't mind and don't get a little like baby seasick. But it's kind of it's a different take to a baby album, but I've never really seen a tutorial where a baby album is from start to finish. And I wanted to show you guys my take on how I do baby albums for others. This is probably my fifth baby album that I have done for someone. I don't have any photos. I basically just plan out an entire album based on, like the stages of, the first year. And that's all this is. It's not trying to go from day one to day, to year 18. It's just the very first year of the baby album. And this particular video just happens to show you guys all the supplies that I intended to use. Intended is the key word right there. So, also too, I wanted to explain to you guys that I don't keep a stash of baby stuff at all. I go through my color bins and see what will work for a baby. I go through my paper pads, which is what I'm doing here, or all my papers, and pull out what I think is baby-ish. And then I also heavily rely on my Cricut. I have thousands of images in my Cricut that are all set and ready to go for babies. It's a perfect spot for them. I don't have to find a space in my craft room to stash for when someone asks for a baby album because they are few and far in between. I definitely don't do a baby album a year. I don't do a baby album a day. So it's kind of one of those that do I make the room for it because I every now and then do it, or am I okay with the Cricut cuts? And the end of the deal is that I am great with the Cricut cuts. It can stay there, and so far my customers absolutely love them. And what I've also learned over the years is how to manipulate those Cricut cuts to kind of freshen them up and not make them look like they're, 10 years old. So that's another thing that I've actually enjoyed over the years as well. Now, one of the other colors that I had to add because there's no way that I can combine blue and pink and make it work in my brain. So I added a neutral and I did the gray and black tones. Now, some of my gray is more of a grayish. It's a little bit on the brown tone, but I think that it works with some of the other papers that I picked out that weren't stark white as well. So I think it's going to come out great. I do want to show you guys a few of the embellishments that I have picked out. Some of them are from close to my heart. Some of them are just random things from my stash. I am going to decorate the album with these two frames on top. That is what she requested, is a frame, photo frames on top of the album for each of the children's photos. And then I picked out some of these glitter embellishments from close to my heart. Again, black, hot pink, and blue. I'm not really sure if I want to do like a glittery album. And then I also have some KaiserCraft blue washi tape and some KaiserCraft. No, those weren't KaiserCraft. Those were Tonic Studios, something Tonic Studios. And then I also have a package of the Stargazer from KaiserCraft. And then these ones here, all of these little die cuts are random leftovers from other previous baby albums that I have done. And these little hearts with the numbers, they are milestone hearts. I just struggle using all that heart, all those hearts, you know, on a layout. But anyways, stay tuned. And I have the next video coming up shortly.